I was looking for a new sport. I was looking for something I could do. I was introduced to it when I was in college, and it was a great opportunity. It was just not just an opportunity to love a sport, which I eventually learned how to love, or love hate, but also it was a great opportunity to be at the cutting edge of a brand new sport for women, and that was part of what I really enjoyed about it all those years. We weren't in the Olympics. We didn't have a world championships. That's when I tried to really make my mark in the sport and tried to get some respect. And that kind of led me down the road of ultimately trying to break a Guinness Book World Record, because we didn't have world records for women at the time. And it was soon after the Guinness Book World Record that I clean and jerked over 137 and a half kilos, which is 303 pounds, and became the first woman in the world to clean and jerk over 300 pounds. The first place that I ever worked out was the White Plains YMCA, and it was down in a basement dungeon of men, and it was just when they opened up the YMCA to women, and I was one of the first women to go down there, and it was a different time. It wasn't, you know, it was, women weren't expected to be lifting heavy weights. In the beginning, it was kind of a lonely road. I guess I did like, to some degree, breaking down some of the male barriers or the female barriers to the male-dominated worlds. I had a great opportunity to work on Wall Street with my father, and I took it. And it, you know, even though it was a male-dominated area, and I think the oddity of a woman. An educated woman, I graduated from Columbia University, someone who, you know, was a financial analyst, someone who maybe didn't look like what you'd expect the strongest woman in the world to look like, and then also at the same time be a very serious athlete, training really hard and trying to be the best I could be at a sport. I was inducted into the USA Weightlifting Hall of Fame by Arnold Schwarzenegger, which was one of my most favorite things to ever happen. I think he's awesome. It was really cool at those events to see young girls, you know, teenagers. They had the teenage division in weightlifting, lifting weights, and coming up to me and appreciating opening the doors. And then I went across the hall to the CrossFit, and they're doing power cleans. And so it just I realized just how much the sport for women has grown from a time when it was taboo. I had heard from some of my patients that there was a CrossFit right down the street from us. And I had been reading on the different, you know, forums, weightlifting forums, about all this controversy about CrossFit. Because in the weightlifting world, some people love it and some people hate it. And it was all this controversy about it, but it sounded really cool. I went on the CrossFit website and saw some crazy stuff that I didn't think I could ever do. and then decided I'm gonna walk in there and introduce myself and give it a try. And I absolutely loved it. It was the hardest workout I had done in a very long time, very reminiscent of when I was training really heavy. You know, I came in sixth. I was really happy. You know, after day one, I was in first place. Saturday, the longer wads, you know, my endurance is not where it should be, or wasn't where it should be, and I knew that I would fall down a little bit with those. But my goal was I want to make it to the top eight, to make it to the finals, so I could be there in the big stadium on Sunday. And that was just like, I did everything I could. On August 22nd, I felt a lump in my breast. And on August 23rd, I had a mammography and was told it looked suspicious. And from there, I went on for more diagnostic testing, biopsy, and all the fun stuff you do. And it was cancer, breast cancer. And so I went on to have, on September 23rd, I had a lumpectomy. It turned out to be what's called triple negative stage 2A breast cancer. And then I went on, after I healed from that, to radiation. And then I went on to chemotherapy. And I had chemotherapy, and I finished my last round of chemotherapy was January 19th. Cancer and cancer treatment has a way of stopping you in your tracks and getting your attention, and there's not much room for anything else. I was optimistic. I knew that, you know, I was feeling good. They had told me that they didn't see any evidence that it had spread to any of my lymph nodes, which I knew was a good sign. So I was always optimistic that I'd get through this.
How did you try and keep your spirits up during that time?
Thinking about CrossFit. Thinking about just good stuff, you know, thinking about memories. The chemo is the hardest part, you know, surgery and radiation, you get through. I trained as much as I could, you know, once everything was healed up, even through the radiation, you're a bit tired, but I would come to the gym and work out as much as I could. The chemo stops you in your tracks for 10 to 12 days after a chemo. It's just this dark hole that you fall into. Your brain shuts down, your body shuts down, and you know, you don't really, just getting up and taking a shower, I needed a 2-hour nap. I would do the best I could for those 10 days to just do what I could do. And then the last week, a week and a half, I would come to the gym and do what I could do. You know, it wasn't anything close to what I was doing, but I figured it's better than doing nothing. So I would try to push myself to do as much as I possibly could, to be as normal as I possibly could, thinking that that's just gonna help my body to be strong as possible. By then, it was announced when the Open was going to be, and by then I was like, okay, I'm going to start training as soon as I can. I knew that I needed 12 days, which is what it was. I started training on January 31st, and I'm like, every day what happens is I feel better, I feel stronger. I'm not 100%. I don't feel, you know, I'm not as strong. My endurance is down. I'm still, you know, I'm working as hard as I possibly can. But my goal has been from throughout this is I'm going to try. I'm going to give it my all. I'm going to do what I can do. And if every week I'm stronger, then every week I'm going to be moving up that leaderboard. Cancer has taught me some patience. And then I'm not in control all the time. And for me, my goal right now is to qualify for the games. And then once I do that, then it's a clear path. And you better watch out. You know, there's something about it that's motivating, you know? And I think that was one of the things that I thoroughly enjoyed and missed. I mean, there's, when you're doing Olympic weightlifting with a team and a coach, you have that group mentality of everyone working together. And that's what we have here at CrossFit. And you know, the coaches are pushing you, you're in a class where everyone's pushing you, and you're pushing them, and that motivation helps. And I think I thrive on a little bit of the of that struggle. I think there's something inside of me that says, okay, you know what, it would be really cool if I could qualify for the games. That would be legendary. That's what I said. I thought it would be just so cool. So, you know, I got to give it everything I've got. And that allows you to draw from everything you have to give it 100%, you know, instead of just going through the motions or think, you know, and I'm, you know, I don't know what's going to happen, you know, and I'm not predicting anything. But in my mind, it's possible. It's absolutely possible. So, you know, that's what I'm going with.